Coffee has taken an important place in human society for at least 1200 years. Today, coffee is among the most widely consumed pharmacological active beverages and its consumption has become a regular part of daily life. We use it to wake up, stay focused and get work done. But there are thousands of questions revolve around the health benefits of this cup of coffee. Whether coffee is good to health, then how much to drink and what are the health benefits. So in this video, we'll try to answer most of your questions. Stay tuned till the end so that you will not miss any unknown facts about coffee. Comment below for any suggestion. You can also follow me on my social media account. Is coffee good for me? Yes, it is, in moderation. The potential benefit from coffee might be from polyphenols, which are plant compounds that have antioxidant properties. But you might think that how can you shore up it? Over last several decades, the coffee has been among heavily studied dietary components. In 1991, coffee was included in a list of possible carcinogens by World Health Organization. By 2016, the research found that this beverage was not associated with an increased risk of cancer. On the contrary, there was a decreased risk of certain cancer among those who drink coffee regularly. So, now you can shore up its health benefits. There has been saying that every food has its limit, so the coffee as well. It is also many of your questions that how much coffee can I drink? Multiple studies have found that a daily coffee intake of 4 cups is safe amount and your cup size should not exceed 8 ounces or 230 ml because cup size differs variedly. When talking about coffee, you can't get away from caffeine. Because caffeine is an active ingredient in coffee, is most commonly consumed psychoactive substance in the world. Coffee's caffeine content is highly variable, ranging from 50 to 400 mg per cup. So the question is, how much is allowed? On an average, your 1 cup 8 ounce brewed coffee contains about 95 mg of caffeine. So, average 400 mg of caffeine per day is recommended. Let us talk little more about this caffeine. Caffeine is non-stimulant, then how does it function? In your brain, it blocks the function of an inhibitory neurotransmitter called adenosine. By blocking adenosine, caffeine increases activity in your brain and releases other neurotransmitters like norepinephrine and dopamine. This reduces tiredness and makes you feel more alert. This is how coffee boosts your mood and keeps you active. Coffee is an intricate mixture of more than 1000 chemicals. Among these major ones are caffeine, vitamin B2, magnesium and polyphenols. In fact, these compounds exhibit various health benefits. Let us see what are the top health benefits of drinking coffee. First one, polyphenols in coffee have been shown to prevent cancer cell growth. Coffee also been associated with decreased estrogen levels, a hormone linked to several types of cancer. Second one, it increases longevity. Recent studies found that coffee drinkers are less likely to die from some of the leading causes of death. Third one, people who drink coffee regularly less likely to get type 2 diabetes. Fourth one, you are less likely to develop heart failure if you are a coffee drinker. Drinking 1 to 2 cups of coffee daily help to increase blood pumping in heart. Fifth one, caffeine is not only linked to lower the chance of developing Parkinson's disease, but it may also help those with condition to better control their movements. Sixth one, coffee supports happiness. Researchers found that drinking coffee is linked to positive emotions including pleasure, kindness, affection, satisfaction, and happiness. The finding also noted that no negative emotions were tied to coffee consumption. If you rely on caffeine to wake you up and keep you going, you are not alone. Millions of people rely on caffeine every day to stay alert and improve concentration. If you are drinking more than 4 cups of caffeinated coffee per day, you may get side effects such as headache, insomnia, nervousness, irritableness, fast heartbeat and muscle tremors. So finally, if you love coffee, enjoy its benefits. But aim for consistency and don't overdo it. As mentioned earlier, restrict your coffee consumption to 4 cups per day. The amount of coffee in each cup of coffee depends on various factors like type of coffee beans used, processing and making, and many more. Here are a few of the caffeine content of brand and coffee. Hope this video answered most of your questions. If you have any, comment below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to share to your friends and family. And if you are new to my channel, subscribe below. I'll be coming with more interesting videos. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye. Take care. Have a great day.